Hello, my name is Kathleen Dormer-Carasone. I am the coordinator for internships and experiential learning here at HACC in the Career Development and Transfer Services Unit. Today, I am going to walk you through the quick and easy steps to activate your College Central Network account. Welcome to College Central Network, otherwise known as CCN, HACC's Career Services Platform. A career services platform provides resources and tools that are completely dedicated to only career services topics. You will be able to explore, discover, and connect to a variety of resources, tools, peoples, and experiences from within your CCN account. Let's get you activated today. There are two ways to access CCN. The first is through your MyHACC student portal, which is what we will use and discuss today. And the second is through CCN's website itself, without going through your MyHACC student portal. Both ways are super simple. You'll log in to your student MyHACC page, which you can see here on this slide is https://my.hacc.edu, and it is a usable link. On this slide, we've divided that page into two halves, one on the left-hand side and one on the right-hand side. You'll see that the page is divided into thirds, and you are going to choose this middle section here where it says Student Success. In that column under Student Success, you'll scroll all the way down until you get to Career Services. And under Career Services, you are going to click the fourth option, College Central Network CCN Internships and Job Opportunities. That's the fourth link under Career Services. When you click that link, this will open HACC's landing page on College Central Network. You'll know you've done it correctly because you'll see in the website address that it is collegecentral.com/HACC, indicated by the bright yellow arrow. Also on this page to the right, on this slide as well, you will see a white login box and activation box. You're going to click on the first option and pull down menu, I am, and when you do that, on this particular slide, you'll click I am, and it's a drop down menu, and you will choose here highlighted a student, which again is indicated by this yellow arrow, and you'll click on that, and when you click on that choice and selection, a student, you'll see this white pop-up box. And this is where you'll be able to actually click on the sign in through school blue button here in the middle of the white pop-up box. When you do that, it is going to open this activate account window. The system automatically provides your user ID. You can see my user ID here is KT Caruso. Yours will be the prefix to your Hawkmail email address. So for example, if your Hawkmail email address was abc123@hawkmail.hack.edu, it would be those letters and numbers before the at symbol, which would be abc123. And then what you'll need to do, as this page indicates, is you'll create your own password, you'll confirm your password following these sets of rules and parameters, and then you'll click on this blue submit button. Once you've created and submitted your password, the new registration page opens. You need to complete the registration in its entirety at one time, meaning in one sitting. You cannot come back to try to save it. It will just disappear. So you complete it in one sitting. You fill out all the red asterisk fields because those are required. and you will use your Hawkmail email as your primary email address, since this is considered your professional student email while you're here at HACC. If you have any questions about any of the other fields, please attend the Benefits of CCN's Resources and Tools Workshop or email us at careerservices@hack.edu and we can assist you with your questions. This next section in filling out your registration is about preferences and qualifications. You'll pay attention to these two red asterisk areas for job location and job interests. For job location, simply choose your state of residence, and you may also select more than one state or location, especially if you're going to be living somewhere else for the summer, you're going to be moving out of Pennsylvania or into Pennsylvania. The point here is you have the ability to make more than one selection for job location. For job interests, I'd like to go over what these mean because sometimes people are confused about their meanings. Typically, full-time, part-time, and seasonal refer to employment. However, these designations or classifications may also apply to any of the other type of job interests you see here. An example would be seasonal, perhaps. Sometimes employers have particularly high volume seasons in which they need additional assistance. So for accounting firms, as an example, for accounting students and or finance students, they may be looking for students on a part-time basis or a full-time basis and as an internship during a seasonal time period, such as tax preparation season, which often runs January through June. Volunteering simply means donating your free time based on a personal and or a career interest. So for example, you may love animals and want to donate your time working with and caring for them at an animal shelter. Or you could be a biology student who's preparing for going to become a vet and you want to do some volunteering time. And that would apply for both personal interests and career interests. Or you could want to help Habitat for Humanity in their housing projects because you want to help people gain access to housing, and or it could be related to your career field, such as building and construction management, engineering, architecture, or any of the trades that are involved in these construction areas. In addition, there's work-based learning. And typically, these are experiences in which you practice work-based skills and or learn about a particular career field. So an example of this here at HACC could be you're in a particular major in which an employer partner has created an opportunity for students to learn skills as it's linked to a particular course. So then they might fill this out as work-based learning. Or it could be that it's an internship and they also include work-based learning based upon the type of tasks and responsibilities that you have at the internship. Or quite simply, it could just be an employer partner who wants to offer job shadowing and informational interviews as options for students to learn more about their career fields. Finally, we have student employment and work study. Student employment is specifically for students who want to work at HACC as student workers. Sometimes student employment may also be a work study opportunity. Work study is often associated with financial aid, or at the very least, qualifying by having submitted a FAFSA, the Free Application for Federal Student Aid form. If you are unsure if you submitted a FAFSA or you checked off work study on your FAFSA form, or if you even qualify for work study, please email HACC's financial aid office at financialaid hacc.edu. These next three sections, degree, major, and graduation date, have drop-down menus. Under degree, since we are a community college, you will see non-degree or continuing education as an option, as well as diploma, certificate, and associates. Under the majors, there will be a pull-down menu with a long list of majors from which you can choose your particular major. Under graduation date, it indicates expected, because sometimes things change and our graduation dates change. You can pull down that menu and choose the month and the expected year of graduation. Finally here, you're finishing your registration out with email authorizations and terms of service. Under the email authorizations, you can select to receive or not receive email notices from both CCN and HACC as your school. I strongly encourage students to receive emails from both CCN and HACC because, number one, they are not plentiful, and number two, they are sent when they're appropriate. So, for example, if you indicated December 2023 as your expected graduation date, in the summer and fall, you can receive an email or emails from CCN about interviewing skills, resume writing, cover letter writing, and any of those career service topics that are related to upcoming and impending graduates. Under terms of service, make sure, like every other site for which you sign up, you read your terms of service agreement, check it off, and then, of course, click on the blue button to save your changes. You now have activated your CCN account. What are the benefits of your HACC CCN account? You can receive career-based announcements when you log in. There are tutorials that teach you how to use certain CCN sections. You can create a career portfolio within the system, which allows you to uniquely market yourself, which is very different from your resume. You can search for experiential learning opportunities like internships, volunteering, and work-based learning. You can listen to career podcasts, register for events and programs like workshops, career and internship fairs, transfer fairs, and much more. You can also search for and report offers and hires of employment. Thank you so much for your time. Contact me for more information or anyone here in the Career Development and Transfer Services Unit with any questions you may have about CCN or its resources and tools at careerservices@hacc.edu. My name again is Kathleen Dormer Carasone. I'm the Internship and Experiential Learning Opportunities Coordinator. I thank you for choosing HACC and being a HACC student. Feel free to call us at 717-780-2433. Have a great day.